Good morning all of you. Today our lesson is depression in freezing point. What is the freezing point? Freezing point of a liquid may be defined as the temperature at which the both liquid and the solid states of that liquid having same vapor pressure. Once again I repeat, the temperature at which the solid and liquid states of a liquid having same vapor pressure, that temperature is called as depression in a freezing point. The freezing point of the solution is always less than that of the freezing point of the pure solvent, because the vapor pressure of the solution is always less than that of the vapor pressure of the pure solvent. The difference in two temperatures is known as depression in freezing point, which is denoted by delta T or delta Tf. If the freezing temperature of the pure solvent is T0 and the freezing point of solution is T, then the depression in freezing point is delta Tf is equal to T0 minus T, where T0 is the freezing point of the pure solvent, T is the freezing point of the solution. Relation between the depression in freezing point and lowering of vapor pressure. Let us consider P0. P0 is the vapor pressure of the pure solvent, P1 is the vapor pressure of the solution 1, and P2 is the vapor pressure of the solution 2. Correspondingly, let us take T0 is the freezing temperature of the solvent, T1 is the freezing temperature of the solution 1, T2 is the freezing temperature of the solution 2. The relation between the depression in freezing point and lowering of vapor pressure can be explained by the vapor pressure curves of the solvent, solution 1 and solution 2. So here, this is the graph, this is x-axis, this is y-axis, T0 is the freezing point of the pure solvent, T1 is the freezing point of the solution 1, T2 is the freezing point of the solution 2. Similarly, P0 is the vapor pressure of the pure solvent, P1 is the vapor pressure of the solution 1, P2 is the vapor pressure of the solution 2. So, take the vapor pressures on y-axis and temperatures on x-axis and plot against the vapor pressures with the temperatures. Now, we got curves like shown in figure. This is the P0 and T0 point. This is the P1 and T0 point. This is the P0, T0 and P2 point. This is the P2, T1 point. This is the P1, T1 point. This is the P2, T2 point. P2, T2 point. Draw a curve from point B. Draw a curve from P0, T0. And let us consider this curve is AB. Similarly, draw a curve which connecting these two points. So draw a curve. This curve is namely as DEF. Similarly, draw a curve which connecting the points H and I. So draw a curve. This is the curve. This curve is called as GHI. And draw a line which connecting the points BFI. So, and namely this is called as BC curve. So, AB is the vapor pressure curve of pure solvent, and DEF is the vapor pressure curve of the solution one, and GHI is the vapor pressure curve of the solution two. If closely observed this plot, there are two triangles in the above curve. That is a triangle BEF, that is a triangle BEF. Triangle BEF, similarly triangle BHI, both are similar triangles. From these similar triangles, we have a relation, we have a mathematical relation, BE by BH is equal to EF by HI. BE by BH is equal to EF by HI. What is BE? BE is the P0 minus P1. What is BH? P0 minus P2. What about EF? T0 minus T1. What about HI? T0 minus T2. Therefore, P0 minus P is directly proportional to T0 minus T. Therefore, delta P is directly proportional to delta TF. So, from the above relation, it is evident that the lowering of vapor pressure is always directly proportional to the lowering of the depression in the freezing point. The depression in freezing point always directly proportional to the lowering in vapor pressure. Therefore, if delta P decreases, then delta TF also decreases. Determination of molecular weight of the solute. From Raoult's law, we have a relation P0 minus P by P0 is equal to N by small n plus capital N. For solute, small m is the weight, small m is the molecular weight, and small w is the weight of the solute. So, number of moles of solute is equal to small w by small m. Similarly, for solvent, let us consider capital W is the weight of the solvent, capital M is the molecular mass or molar mass or molecular weight of the solvent. So, number of moles of solvent is equal to capital W by capital M. P0 minus P by P0 is equal to P0 minus P by P0 is equal to small W by small M into capital M by capital W. This is from Raoult's law. By neglecting the small n in the denominator. Therefore, P0 minus P and manu raaskochu delta TF by P0 is equal to small W by small n into capital M by capital W, where P0 and capital M are the constants. Therefore, delta TF is directly proportional to capital W by small w by small m into 1 by capital W. Therefore, delta TF is inversely proportional to molecular weight. Molecular weight of the solute. Here, once again, manam okkasari gamaniste ikkada delta TF is directly proportional to small w by small m into 1 by capital W in cages. Therefore, dinni ela raaskuntam, dinni jartha gamaniste delta TF is directly proportional to small w by small m into 1000 by capital W in grams. Dinne molality antam, danne antam molality. Therefore, delta TF is directly proportional to molality. Delta TF is equal to KF into M. K Kf into Km. Kf is called as depression constant, and where small m is called as molality. Therefore manaki em ostadi, delta Tf is equal to small double by small m into 1000 by capital M. మనకి స్మాల్ ఎం కావాలి. స్మాల్ ఎం ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఏమవుద్ది, మనకి కేఎఫ్ కూడా ఉంది ఇక్కడ, కేఎఫ్ ఇంటూ డబ్ల్యూ బై డెల్టా టీఎఫ్ ఇంటూ 1000 బై క్యాపిటల్. సో బై యూజింగ్ దిస్ రిలేషన్ వీ క్యాన్ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ ది మాలిక్యులర్ వెయిట్ ఆఫ్ ది సొల్యూట్, నాన్ వాలటైల్ సొల్యూట్, ఇఫ్ వీ నో ద డిప్రెషన్ ఇన్ ఫ్రీజింగ్ పాయింట్. మనకి డిప్రెషన్ ఇన్ ఫ్రీజింగ్ పాయింట్ కనుక తెలిస్తే మనం వాల్యూస్ని మనం కనుక్కోవచ్చు. ఓకే, థ్యాంక్ యూ. ప్లీజ్ లిజన్ ద వీడియో 2 or 3 times అండ్ మేక్ నోట్స్. ఇట్ లీడ్స్ టు ఎఫెక్టివ్ లెర్నింగ్. థ్యాంక్ యూ వన్ అండ్ ఆల్.